Let's start. Hello everyone. Today I have a very special person, my bhaiya here from Nepal. Samir bhaiya, namaste.
Namaste. Hariom.
Hariom bhaiya. Samir bhaiya, can you tell a little bit about yourself? हम लोग हिंदी में भी बात कर सकते हैं. I mean, I am not Hindi.
Myself Samir Kumar. I am from Kathmandu, Nepal. I am brought up in Himalayas and I am brought up in ashram environment from very childhood, grown up in ashram. So from very childhood, I was introduced to the system of yoga, spirituality, healing, and all these things. And my grandfathers, my uncles are also a healer. So healing, yoga, spirituality is always a part of my life. So finally, I came to yoga and spirituality. Now I am a yoga teacher, sound healer, and yoga therapist.
Thank you, bhaiya. Now, when you say sound healing technique, how did you gain that interest? From young age, you liked being in silence and being in the ashram. How did you develop this interest?
From very childhood, I was introduced in yoga and meditation. I used to do lots of meditation from childhood. And in Nepal, singing bowl was quite common, but also I didn't have that knowledge about singing bowl. Then one day, we have in our ashram, many foreigners used to come. And one day, I was taking a group of foreigners to sound healing session. And I was sitting outside, and then the owner of that group, that organization who used to give sound healing, you also come, it is free for you. You come and you experience once. He requests me. Then I think, okay, I'll go. And I went for the session. It was a 45-minute session. The session was over. But after the session also, I was not able to come back. I get into such a deep state of meditative state. Like later he told me that you were in that state for at least more than half an hour. After around 40 minutes, I came back after the session. It was not like I was not sleeping. I was in deep state of meditation and I was so happy, so fresh, so happy, and so in such a peaceful thing which I've never experienced. And I thought I meditate daily, sometimes 3-4 hours continuously, but also I didn't get that deep experience of meditation, which I get in the first session of singing bowl. Then I start exploring our singing bowl. So from then, the journey of singing bowl started. I went to many different masters in Nepal, in India, and I went to Upper Himalayas to search actual the Buddhist monk who teaches singing bowl. And it is very difficult journey to find the actual teacher. But somehow with the Guru's grace, God's grace, when your intention is so high and pure, you will ultimately get it. Same thing happened. I found my guru, I found different teachers who helped me a lot in this journey to accumulate this beautiful knowledge of singing bowl, sound healing.
Bhaiya, I want to ask you, like, what was that phase in your life where you thought yoga and therapy and you have to come into the spiritual line? I know you were not like this before, right? So what was that phase in your life as to changed you so much?
What I mean is, before I was in very yogic environment, I used to stay in ashram. Suddenly, this came in life, then I get distracted from that path. Then I was like normal child who used to enjoy the materialistic world so much, just going outside, enjoying roaming. This one, as a part of my teenage, I was enjoying that things only. Then at that phase, I decided to go to abroad. I go to Europe and I settled there. I think accumulating the money, accumulating the wealth is the biggest thing in the life which we have to do. So my only aim was to gain money. So I was planning to go to Europe, and as my mother was also there, so I think I will go to Europe and I will accumulate money. I will enjoy the life, whatever I can, in the fullest. Then at that point, my Guruji, Mamaji, who is the founder of our ashram, Sri Aurobindo Yoga Nepal, where I stay, he told me, he told me, you are born in ashram environment. So I request you, at least you once go to the place where I send you and you experience 1 year course there. Then after that, wherever you want, you can go. Then he sent me to Vihari School of Yoga.
Yes.
Where I met my Guruji, where I did 1 year diploma course in advanced yogic studies. After meeting my Guru, after going to the ashram, everything changed. Life take a U-turn. Then I understand why I was born. There are many, many interconnections. Why I was born in a family of spiritual family. Why I was associated with that. When I start understanding the laws of karma, the past life, all these things get interconnected. Like the puzzle, once the puzzle get fixed, it becomes so beautiful. Same thing like all the missing puzzles get come in one place, and I realize what I am meant for, what I should pursue in my life. Then my spiritual journey, I mostly focus on spiritual journey. Then I think the aim of life is to help other, to achieve the divinity within oneself, to experience the divinity, which is the part and parcel of us. And that becomes the goal of life. And then I completely dedicate my life to yoga and spirituality.
Wow, Bhaiya. Bhaiya, you told about Guru. But many people will be working under a Guru only. But how do you get connected so much to the Guru? Like, you found your Guru in Swami Niranjanananda from Bihar School of Yoga. So how will I know that, yes, I have found the Guru? Because I have not yet felt that.
Like, it is telling, when you are ready, Guru automatically appears. And when your knowledge is matter, automatically Guru disappears. Same thing happened with me. I never was in search of Guru, but automatically, maybe it was the past karma that dragged me to the that part. And by seeing him, I realized, okay, I have found the right person. This should be my Guru automatically. Then luckily he gave me Diksha. Then I took Diksha from him, then follow the tradition. And then after getting Diksha, it is like you are connected with the Guru.
Yes.
You don't need a physical life. If you go to our life of our Guruji, he came to ashram at the age of 4. At the age of 10, he went abroad. He was sent to America to open the ashram, to take the yoga movement in a big platform, where he never met his Guru. But he always used to say that, I never met my Guru, but I never felt his absence.
Correct.
That always motivated me, and that always encouraged me that we shouldn't focus on the physical presence. Once you are connected in this universe, nothing is separated. We all are interconnected. We should just maintain that connection.
Yes. Yes.
Which is just beyond the
Physical.
Yeah, beyond this time and space. Because it is something very deep and subtle.
True. Whenever
I feel any problem in my life, automatically the guidance will come from him in some way or other.
Yes. That is really surprising, actually. And you're so lucky to have found your Guru.
That is the connection. Once you are devoted to Guru, automatically the connection will happen. You don't have to just rely on the physical presence.
True. Also, talking about singing bowl therapy, Bhaiya, can you give us some major benefits? Tell us who can perform or who can participate in the singing bowl therapy and who should not?
One of the most important thing is anyone can participate in this thing. If you have some ear problem, like there is one specific thing, I don't know the name of that. In that, your ear will amplify the sound very much.
Yes.
So that you can tolerate the sound. Besides from that, anyone can participate in this. There is no side effect. It is totally side effectless. It is just the sound of the balls, which are made up of 7 different metals. And if you see the history in olden days, it was used, if you believe that, it was used by Buddhist monks. Buddhist monks, they use for their spiritual growth, not for healing or doing other things. They use for their spiritual purpose, for opening their chakra to go to deeper meditative state. And later, other people find the effect of this, the healing effect of these balls. Then slowly it came to us as a healing balls in these days. But actual purpose of these things are higher for higher spiritual practices.
Spiritual, okay.
And then people believe that Buddhist monks used to take this ball and go outside the people's house and just play the balls.
Correct.
And listening to so beautiful, the attracting sound, people of the house would come and give the alms to them without saying the word. And then they were so attracted to the sound, and then slowly, slowly, singing ball became the part of the Nepalese house. Like if you go to the many Nepalese house, in old house, you can find a singing ball in each house. And if you sing in some tradition, in Nepalese tradition, they tell you have to put in singing ball during pregnancy. Very good.
Correct. Correct.
And like you can find singing ball in each house, like as an antique piece, something which is very auspicious.
Also, Bhaiya, can children also participate?
Absolutely, very fine, because they will be so calm. Once they are calm, their memory, their concentration will increase. It is very good for children, and it is very good to introduce children to such things. Because nowadays, we are losing who we are.
Correct.
Especially children. If we can introduce something which is so scientific, so amazing, then they will be attracted. Unlikely they will come to the spiritual path. These things can help you direct to the spiritual path.
True.
It is very good, very, very beneficial for children. And like we have done one experiment in our ashram where we gave them singing ball therapy for the children. We measured their memory and concentration after the session and before the session. And we found a very good result that the memory and attention has increased a lot.
Wow.
So it is very good for children.
Yes. And how frequently can we participate, Bhaiya? Can we listen to the therapy sessions?
Like, how you use, like if you have some specific problem, if you want therapy, then accordingly, like 3 days in a week, 7 days in a week, we give therapy according to the condition of the disease. If you want for spiritual practice, we tell them to do it daily. So,
correct.
According to your availability, according to your time, you can fix.
Also, by your coming
like
to
we have to do this much, like it is not like some allopathic medicine that you have to eat 2 times or 3 times.
Correct.
According to your time, you can do it. It don't have any restrictions.
Okay. Bhaiya, coming to spirituality, many of them think that once I get into the journey of spirituality, I should totally avoid everything. I don't want any material things. I don't want this world. Let me go to Himalayas and totally be alone to myself. So you think that is a path of spirituality, or staying here in this present world and doing yoga and taking a longer time and being amongst the society, that is spirituality according to you?
Spirituality doesn't mean, you can't find any place. Spirituality doesn't mean that you have to leave the whole world and go to be settled in the Himalayas.
Yeah.
No one said that. It is just a misinterpretation of the word spirituality. Spirituality means connect to your inner self, the spirit. Connect to your inner spirit, knowing who you are, drawing our inner self, knowing our inner reality, that Sachit Ananda, where nothing is the bliss, that truth, where the part and parcel of that divinity, and we are that part, and we are to be made to blissful, not full of sorrow, anger, anxiety. Knowing these things and spreading this message, helping others to gain that absolute bliss is spirituality. You don't have to be separate from the family, or you don't have to wear veil, live in the cave. It is not like that. But in beginning, to control the mind, to get that, some of them dedicated in that way. But it doesn't mean that you have to separate everything. There are many, many masters who were married, who live in a simple household life and achieve the highest.
Correct.
Like you can see the Guru of Paramahamsa, Yogananda, godly master. Oh, then you can see Paramahamsa Ramakrishna, Aurobindo, they all are married.
True.
They have achieved the highest. You see the recent master like Swami Pandit Gopinath, all these, these were the married person, but they also they have achieved the highest. And if you see our Guruji, our Param Guruji, Swami Satyananji, he had a beautiful concept of karma yoga. Where you can live as a household life, but you can achieve the highest.
Yes.
You can do normal day to day, or as well as you can do a special one.
Correct.
If, according to me, when we can mix this both the thing and get a better combination of both the things, speciality as well as meditation, then it is the best life to live. I think we have to live a 200% of life, 100% materialistic, 100% spiritual. But it doesn't mean that we have to have that much craving. But with spirit, once you are spiritual, there won't be have that craving. And once I, what I believe is all the money, power should come on the spiritual person, so that they will be
correct.
Positive way. If you see, like the Aurobindo, the mother concept about money, about material things, then you will understand it is very beautiful.
Correct.
They tell that the spiritual person have a money, they will use it in positive way, in a good way. But the one who is just full of material things with so much sympathy, he will use for his benefit. You cannot use for other benefit, use it in the wrong way. So it is always good to be spiritual as well as materialistic at the same time. The balance of both things is very important in the world.
By a one now.
Realize the self.
Correct.
So being in this world, we can work for that.
Correct. Bhaiya, one more thing. Actually, many of them try to do the chakra meditation or kundalini meditation, which is super high energy meditations as such, following YouTube or following something on the internet without a guru. And also we have seen in our own ashram in the campus as to they end up in a state where they are not themselves. So how important it is to follow a guru or follow somebody who should guide you in that way instead of doing on your own?
You see, all the yogic practices are sacred practices which should be learned under the proper guru and practice under the recommendation of guru.
Correct.
You cannot say like, I like this practice, I will go to this practice.
Correct.
Like, if there is, like, we don't believe that we just want to jump to meditation and kundalini, all these things.
Yes.
But
yes.
If you see the level of this, like, Yama, Niyama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana,
Samadhi.
Samadhi. Dharana, Dhyana, come on, is seventh. We don't realize these things. Just we want to jump. Like it is like class 1 children want to read the syllabus of class 10.
Correct.
What will happen? They will not understand anything. They will just stress themselves and they will have the negative impact. Same thing is happening. Now, mostly in the West, if you see the Western, they are so much attracted towards the. These things due to the advancement of technology, we're so easily getting the knowledge from many sources like YouTube, all these things, but they are not that authentic.
Correct, correct.
That is not the way to learn this spiritual practice. You should go on, because each one of us our own body type, own karma, own sanskara.
Yes.
And so according to that, guru will find which practice is best for you. And he will advise the best practice according to your body, according to your karma, according to your level.
Correct.
But we don't know our level. We are just class 1 level, but we have to practice PhD level.
Correct.
Then it is like destroying our own self. And it is very wrong, very bad practices happening in yoga and spirituality.
Yes, yes. Thank you, Bhaiya, for the clarification. Also, thank you so much for coming in today. I know we have just finished a sound healing session and I asked Bhaiya to come in today, right now. So thank you for coming in and answering the questions. Bhaiya, if people want to reach out to you for your sound healing sessions, how can they reach out to you? Can they contact you via mail or your number?
They can contact me through Instagram and my number.
We'll end the session. Okay. Thank you, Bhaiya. Thank you. Sorry for like hurrying you up, but good. Thank you, Bhaiya.
No, it's fine. Okay.
Bye.